Dear learners, I welcome all of you in NIOS studio. Myself, Dr. Aman, working in Central University of Jammu. Friends, today we are going to have interaction on the topic which is related to your paper number 510, and the name of the topic is Types of Investigation in Class and Out of School. So, before going to the main lesson, I will try to enumerate the learning objectives, which are after this lesson, the learners will be able to define the term investigation, describe the purpose of investigation in the curriculum, elaborate the types of activities in inquiry or investigation, describe the investigation in learning of science, enumerate the phases of investigative process, elaborate various aspects of inquiry based science education, and lastly, they will be able to discuss the various types of investigations along with relative examples. As you know, learners, teaching science is complex and demanding. If the aims of teaching science in schools is to develop conceptual understanding, procedural knowledge, understandings of the nature of science, usefulness, and associated socio-scientific issues that conceptualize a scientifically literate individual. Now, friends, firstly, I will try to discuss or define the term investigation. Many dictionaries, many scientists, many philosophers tried to define the term investigation, but briefly I would like to quote the definition advocated by Oxford Dictionary, that is Allen 1991. He said, investigation means to inquire or to study carefully. As per Collins Dictionary, the act of process of investigating, a careful search or examination in order to discover facts, etc. So, friends, as you just listen to the definition of investigation, so particularly in sciences, a student, a learner has to examine the various factors behind a particular phenomena. They will try to discover various facts, processes underlying, and that all will be included in the investigation. Now, friends, I would like to share with you people the purpose of investigation in the curriculum. Firstly, the purpose of including investigation in the curriculum is related to the heuristic approach. The term heuristic or the word heuristic is derived from a Greek word heurisko, which means to discover. So, obviously, the purpose of investigation in the science curriculum is to make a learner a discoverer one. Secondly, nowadays new philosophical aspect, or you can say psychological aspect, is in limelight, that is constructivism. As per constructivism, we have to make the learners to construct knowledge at their own level. We have to provide the situations, such situations where they will be able to describe or construct knowledge at their own with the help of some of the evidences collected by them from time to time. Thirdly, through investigation, we try to encourage pupils to express their ideas related to any phenomena, any event related to science on which they are working or watching. And lastly, the main belief behind investigation is to develop scientific literacy among the students or the learners. Now, proceeding ahead, friends, I would like to discuss with you people the various types of activities involved in inquiry or investigation. There are four or three such inquiries, that is, scientific inquiry, inquiry learning and inquiry teaching. So, these are three types of activities which are involved in investigation. Firstly, I am coming to the scientific inquiry. Scientific inquiry refers to the characteristics of the scientific enterprise and processes through which scientific knowledge is acquired. So, friends, in scientific inquiry, any process of science, any enterprise, the learner has to see the characteristics, has to inquire about the characteristics of that particular process. That will be scientific inquiry. Second activity is inquiry learning. It is obvious from the word also itself, that is, in this particular type, the learner is actively involved, because he has to learn something by inquiry. So, he will be active, he will be thinking, he will be delving into the various procedures. That means, he will try to dig up the various procedures involved in a particular topic of the science. Now, third activity is inquiry teaching, which is basically pedagogical approach for the teacher. That means, how a particular teacher of a science deliver the curriculum of science with the help of investigation. That means, how investigation can be used as a methodology of teaching particular subjects of the science. Of course, it is extended inquiry into a question of interest to the students in any area. You know, we should teach the students in which they are interested. So, in investigation also, we should try to give such topics in which students take interest. Now, I will particularly come to the science investigation. So, friends, science investigation is a holistic approach to learning science through practical work. It is holistic, but the learning which will be happening in the learning of science, that will be through practical works. In this, the students are provided opportunities to use various concepts which are related with the sciences. Their cognitive processes, how the students are thinking, what kind of knowledge they are already possessing, what kind of skills they are lying with the students. So, all these things, we have to provide the opportunities that they should be able to use all these things to strengthen their knowledge. As Miller in 2010 has defined investigation as, in this we give freedom to choose the procedures to follow and to decide how to record, analyze and report the data collected. Friends, whenever the students are involved in an investigative process, it is almost related to a research. As the way you conduct a research in day to day settings, in maybe in humanities, maybe in sciences, that way we have to give freedom to the learners that they should be able to choose their processes, where from they have to collect the data. And obviously, after data collection, they have to analyze the various things involved, and at last they should be given the freedom to arrive at the subjective conclusions. Every student should have the freedom to reach at their specific or subjective conclusions. Now, friends, we will discuss about the phases of investigative process, which are pointed as four in number. These are a design and planning phase. Whenever a student is involved in an investigative process, firstly we have to design and plan. Without designing or planning, nothing will be fruitful. So, it is very important phase. Second, a performance phase, where students are to be given liberty, where they have to perform independently. Then, reflection phase, where what they gained in performance phase, they will try to reflect through some media, maybe through writing, maybe through any other thing. And last phase is recording and reporting, what they came up with, the things they have worked on. Now, they will point out or they will record and they will report those investigations, maybe in written or maybe in oral manner. And friends, these phases are not sequentially, they are not working sequentially, but they work concurrently. That means, they are almost related to each other, they are connected with each other while we are planning. So, planning will be connected with the performance. Obviously, performance will be connected with the reflection and thereby the reporting. Now, friends, we will discuss the various aspects of inquiry based science education, which are 6 in number. We will discuss them one by one. These 6 are basic principles behind the inquiry based approach: unity and variety in inquiry based approach, inquiry and iterative process, then concrete implementation of inquiry based approach, leaving a record and assessment. So, firstly, I will be coming to basic principles behind the inquiry based approach. So, we will just concentrate on some points. That means, there are some principles on which this whole approach is based. First is the need to take ownership of the initial question. That means, question will be in the shape of a problem. So, we have to take the ownership that we are posing the student with this much of problem. Secondly, the need for individual experimentation. Every student, friends, is to be given the opportunity that he or she should be able to investigate or experiment independently. Then, you can see only what you strive to see. We can see the things, friends, what we want to see. So, we have to keep these things in mind. Then, a great deal of information can be found in documentation, but it can be found even more easily by those who know what they are looking for. So, documentation, what you want to see in the particular document, how you want to relate that theory or information which is contained in the document, is it going to be helpful for you people for solving your particular problem? So, that is to be taken care. Then, learning is not only acting on and with objects, it is also talking with other children and writing both for oneself and for others. Second variety is, that is unity and variety in the inquiry based approach. So, friends, obviously, when the students are involved in investigative process, there will be a kind of unity in various things. Likewise, when he or she is involved in an investigative process, he has to plan a hypothesis, which is nothing but preconceived solution of the problem. So, then he will be applying the reasoning to solve that problem. He will be going to the field and obviously coming to the conclusion after the analysis of the information. So, you see, there will be unity in the all aspects of the various steps of the investigation. Then obviously, students can use variety of the methods. Some of them are direct experimentation, item production, maybe the use of the computer or investigation production of radio program or short film, and of course, maybe a tour. So, variety of methods are there which can be used to adopt inquiry based approach. Third is inquiry and iterative process. Friends, when we involve the students in a particular investigation, we cannot expect him to reach immediately at the final step or at the conclusion. So, that is why we consider investigation as a iterative process, meaning thereby that is repetition of various steps, or you have to proceed step by step to reach at the particular conclusion or the goal. So, each step will be consolidated, then you have to move to the second step. Fourth is concrete implementation of an inquiry based approach. How we can apply, concretely we can apply inquiry based approach. So, friends, here we will concentrate on the following points. That means how to choose the starting situation, what should be the problem, what should be the starting point of the investigation, we have to concentrate on that. What questions should be asked of the children and how to ask them? This is the mastery of the teacher or the facilitator, how he is asking the questions to the students. Taking into account students' questions and ideas. Holding group discussion, which is very important part of the investigation. Obviously, students will be sharing their own experiences and coming to the conclusions. Then designing experimental protocol, how the experiment to be conducted. Then class organization, what would be the duty, what kind of groups you are going to frame, or you are making the student to be independently working on a particular investigation or experiment. Then guiding the students as they design protocol, identify suitable variables and become aware of need to control the variables. Taking each student's results into account, connecting them back to the initial hypothesis and summarizing the information. And lastly, comparing and contrasting the established facts. Friends, what should be the generalization, where students are supposed to reach. So, now where he reached after the investigation. So, we have to compare his results with the actual, what we want from the student. So, that way we can compare his progress. Fifth aspect is leaving a record. Now, all things are done, we have applied concretely about inquiry based approach. Now, our final thing is that we have to leave the record, and records may be in the shape of individual writing, may be intermediate group writing, or may be class or group writing. And obviously, all endeavors may be fruitless if we did not conduct any kind of assessment. Without assessment, friends, there is no use of the teaching, but in such approach, the assessment will be in the shape of formative assessment, in which we will try to see the various aspects of students' activities, that is how they observe, how they express their predictions, explanations, experimental protocol, how they gather information and how they grasp the concept and acquire particular skills. So, on the basis of all these things, we will try to grade the performance of the students. So, now friends, we are coming to the last phase of this topic, that is types of investigation, which is of course, practical part. What kind of investigations can be conducted? I will point out or list up very few of them due to the paucity of the time, but it is the creativity of the science teacher. He or she can think freely, conduct various kinds of, or think of various kinds of problems, which of the levels of the students, which students can solve at their own. So, first of its type is fear testing, where we try to see the systematic changes in the independent variable, which are compared with the changes in the outcome or the dependent variable. That means, in fear testing, the student or the learner will operate on the independent variable, the result of which will be seen on the dependent variable. For example, I have given in the slides, that is what affects the rate at which the sugar dissolves in the water. What is the rate of dissolve if you are taking hot water, if you are taking cold water? So, you can ask your student to see at what rate the sugar is dissolving. That will be the example of fear testing. I have quoted more examples like which is the strongest paper bag. So, likewise, you can engage the students in fear testing also. Second category is classifying and identifying. So, obviously, clear from the topic also that in classifying, the student will arrange a particular phenomena into different manageable sets. And in identification, he will observe each set individually, and he can give the specific names to those subsets, and he can also investigate those subsets and investigate about the various phenomena involved in those particular subsets. Its examples may be, you can ask your students, what is this chemical? You can see the classification of various chemicals, like I have quoted the example of invertebrates, such organisms, those who are not having backbone. So, how we will be categorizing, classifying those organisms. So, such kind of investigations can be used by the students. Thirdly, pattern seeking. Friends, in these investigations, they involve observing and recording natural phenomena or carrying out surveys and then seeking patterns in their findings. Here I have quoted some examples related to this. For example, do people with longer legs jump higher? So, this is related to the pattern seeking, why it is happening, how you will be able to see the this kind of pattern, what are the various things involved behind these phenomena. One example I have written, do dandelions in the shade have longer leaves than those in the light? This is a variety of plants. So, those who are grown in shade, they will be having longer leaves, and those in light, they will be having shorter length. So, you can ask your students to observe these kinds of patterns. Fourth is exploring. So, here pupil either make careful observations of objects or events, or makes a series of observations of a natural phenomena occurring over a time. Here, the time factor is mainly involved, friends. Students have to explore, as I have quoted in the example, that how does frog spawn develop over a time? What happens when different liquids are added together? What will be happening, friends? You can give the scattering of light. So, such kind of examples, how these are happening over the passage of the time. So, students can explore, they can be involved in such type of investigations, where they have to explore certain kind of phenomena. Friends, first is investigating models, which is already occurring, friends. So, you can ask your learners to investigate various established models, as I have indicated in the example, that how does cooling takes place through insulating materials. Such kind of, so many examples are there involved, which are already established models. Means, while you are cooking in the mountains, would it take more time or less time? So, these kind of already investigative models, you can, why you feel warm after putting on sweaters? Is there any machine which is implanted in the sweaters? So, you can ask your students to investigate about such kind of things, such models, scientific models, scientific phenomena which are already developed. Next or last is making things or developing systems. Here we expect from the students to develop some small systems as per their levels of learning. May it be requiring a kind of high scientific knowledge, friends, as I have quoted in the examples. Can you find a way to design a pressure pad switch for a burglar alarm? So, obviously, student will be requiring the related knowledge through which they can prepare such things, because they have to develop the system at their own. Then how could you make a weighing machine out of elastic band? So, such kind of things you can think over, and you can engage your students in such kind of activities. To conclude, friends, I would like to narrate that in today's interaction, we try to investigate, or we try to elaborate the term investigation. We see what is the purpose of investigation in the curriculum, in which we try to discuss the heuristic approach, the constructivist approach, which seems to be very beneficial in respect of the investigation, while you have to engage your students in the investigation. Then, of course, we tried to see the various types of activities which are involved in the investigation, the investigation in learning of sciences, we deliberated on this thing also. Then we tried to explore the various phases of investigative process. We also discussed about the various aspects of inquiry based science education, and of course, lastly, we tried to see various types of investigations. We discussed those types of investigations. We tried to quote various types of investigations, and friends, I want to share with my would be teachers also that the sky is the limit. You should be a creative teacher, which is very, very beneficial for the students. Don't teach science within the four walls of the classrooms. You should try to do something new. Your classroom should look like a laboratory. The student should always be involved in some processes. You should apply, or you should fix a board in that particular laboratory which your classroom should be converted into. The student should be in a position to write their problems on the board. They should investigate the various processes. Maybe in the class, they should be allowed to go out, they should come back, they should write the various things which they learnt from their investigation. So, that way, friends, you can try to be a creative teacher, and you should try to use investigation as a pedagogical approach in the teaching and learning of the sciences for the students. With these words, I say thanks to all the listeners. I am highly thankful to the NIO studio who gave me opportunity to deliver lecture on this particular topic. Thank you very much.